There's two arguments, right? The one argument is we need to keep going, protect the weak, protect the sick, but let's open up the economy. The other argument is stop placing money over human lives and let's shelter in place until we come up with some sort of a decision, and let's figure out some way to develop some sort of a universal income, universal basic income plan or something like that to feed people during the during this time. When we make this transition,
I think there's a as I said, my opinion is if somebody wants to stay home, they should stay home. And if somebody doesn't want to stay home, they should not be compelled to stay home. That's my opinion.
Do you think
if somebody doesn't like that, well, that's my opinion. This notion though that you can just sort of send checks out to everybody and things will be fine is not true. Obviously, some people have this absurd, view that the economy is like some magic horn of plenty. Like it just makes stuff, whatever. There's a magic horn of plenty, and the goods and services, they just come from this magic horn of plenty. And then if somebody has more stuff than somebody else, it's because they took more from this magic horn of plenty. Now let me just break it to the fools out there. If you don't make stuff, there's no stuff. Yeah. So if you don't make the food, if you don't process the food, you don't transport the food, and the medical treatment, getting your teeth fixed, there's no stuff. I would become detached from reality. You can't just legislate money and solve these things. If you don't make stuff, there is no stuff.